Here is a proof of the ratio test, testing to see if a series converges or not. So you start off with your series and you build up this ratio of the next value divided by the previous. And if it has a limit, then we'll call that limit L. Okay, so here is your, you take this limit of these ratios of absolute values of the next term divided by the previous. And you see what that limit is, and it comes out L. So here's the cases. If L is less than 1, then our original series converges. And that's what we're going to prove. If L is greater than 1, then if L is infinite, then AN diverges. Okay, so that's case 2. Case 3 is if L turns out to be equal to 1, then the test is inconclusive, and we'll show why that is. So first we're going to start off with case 1. Here is the proof that you have to know for a test. Case 1, L is less than 1. So you set up your ratio equal to L, and that L turns out less than 1. That's the case 1. Since the limit is L, that means something from the definition of what a limit is. It means that eventually there will be a capital N value, such that for all the little n, beyond that N, capital N, the ratio will be less than epsilon away from L for some x value between L and 1. So that is a mouthful. So let's see what the explanation of that is. So what that sentence just said there was that your ratios will end up being in this band about L eventually for some n greater than or equal to n. So you take these an values, and once you get up to this n, they're going to be within epsilon away from the L. They have to be, because L is the final destination limit. So eventually you're going to have to get close to that, and you have to stay in that band. So n is the counter number on the a's that achieves that this ratio will be this close in between here and here, and here's your x. And x is less than 1, and all those are greater than 0 over here. Okay, so now, that means that for that dot A with those subscripts of capital N plus 1, and this one's capital N, that ratio is going to be less than x. As you can see, the ratio is in this band, and all those values are less than x. Okay, so this ratio is going to be less than x, guaranteed. And if it's not guaranteed, you pick the wrong capital N, you'll have to pick a larger one. So eventually, there will be that capital N so that this is true. So then you just multiply over the AN, and those are positive because the absolute value, so you get this statement here. Then similarly, you say, okay, so what about AN plus 2 divided by the previous AN plus 1 absolute value? That's also less than x, because all those ratios beyond the original N are all less than x. They're all in this band. So you get to multiply this over, and you get this absolute value is less than x times that one, but then this here is this one, which is less than x times absolute value an. So this means that this term here is less than x times absolute value of an. You see, this is less than this one, and that substitutes in to become this. And that happens to equal x squared times. So what we're doing here is building up a geometric series. Okay, so then, one more time. Similarly, let's say you take n plus 3, a sub n plus 3, and divide it by its previous value. That's also less than x, guaranteed. Multiply over, and you get that this is less than x times a n plus 2. But that one is less than x times what was a n plus 2 less than? Oh, it was less than x squared times. So we just substitute in the x squared times the absolute value a n, and then x times x squared is x cubed times this. So that means that if you add up these terms like this, they're all going to be less than the terms that they were proven less than, forever this way and forever this way. Okay, so this one here was proven to be less than this. This one was proven to be less than this one. This one was proven to be less than this one, and so on. So that inequality holds. Then what we do, just to make it look like a geometric series on the right, we just add it on here, here, and here. Just added that term on to both sides. That's okay. And then we see that this left-hand side, that sum series, is from n, little n, from capital N to infinity, absolute value a n. That's what that left-hand sum is. And the right-hand sum is a n plus this, just like it says there. And that is the geometric series of a constant, because a capital N is not changing. That's a specific term in the series, and that is a constant multiplying by the x, the 1, the x squared, x squared. That's a geometric series that we already know from previous that converges to this constant number over 1 minus x. Okay, so it converges. So this series here is less than a convergent series. Oh yeah, and one more thing. That geometric series does converge to this because the absolute value of x is less than 1. Because remember, x was less than 1 and greater than 0. So this is definitely true. Okay, so that means that this series here, which is that one, same thing, converges because it's less than a series that converges. That means by a previous theorem that we proved that if the series of the absolute values of the terms converge, then so did the original series. So that means this original series converges. Now, I make this statement, n equals 1 to infinity of the series converges, because, of course, the 1 to the n minus 1, all the other terms that I added in here when I had it start from 1 instead of starting at n, that's just a finite number. Those just add up into whatever sum they are, and those add on to a convergent series, so that, of course, that sum is also converging. So case 1 done. Now we'll go to another video to do case 2.